ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. जस्ट क्विकली ओपन योर मैथ मैजिक बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट टू टूडे आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस फॉर टुमोरोज असेसमेंट. ओके, सो सम चैप्टर्स ऑफ पी टी वन टूडे वी विल रिवाइज. सो काइंडली कम टू मैथ मैजिक. मैथ मैजिक, गुड मॉर्निंग, कम टू मैथ मैजिक. Come to math magic. The first chapter is building with brick, and as you know, from tomorrow you have your assessment, isn't it? So those who don't know, kindly follow our school's website. Kindly follow our school's website. It is give every type of information is given there, and how to give the exam also, that is also given there. Okay. So kindly follow that one. Listen, mute your microphone. Everyone, mute your microphone. There is a noise. Mute your microphone. Yes. So regarding assessment, all types of information you will get it from our website, and kindly follow that website. And only one thing I have to say, that don't refresh your mobile or your computer while giving the exam, okay? And don't give backspace, don't even click to the backspace, so that not backspace means backward. So if you are doing that, the whole paper will be vanished. So kindly don't do that. Just open the question paper, there will be 20 MCQs, solve that 20 MCQs and give a tick mark or the dot, whatever is given. Either if it is told to give a tick mark, then you will give tick mark, or if it is told to give a dot, then you give the dot to the correct answer, and then solve the problem and submit it. Okay, so I think there will be not any problem from tomorrow. And I want to discuss, as I have told you, regarding this building with bricks. Okay, quickly come to math magic, chapter number 1, building with bricks, and page number 4. Directly come to page number 4. See, in page number 4, there are some questions related to the bricks. And as you know, that brick is the three-dimensional shape of cuboid, isn't it? So from the composite maths, you will practice that three-dimensional shapes. Okay, so here it is given that how many faces in all does a brick have. So that you will write 6, isn't it? Then is any face a square? You will write no, any of the face of a brick is not a square. Actually, the face of the brick is rectangular. The face of the brick is rectangular. Okay. So this type of question can come in exam, even the face of the brick and the drawing of the brick. As you know, when it is asked the face of the brick, so only the rectangular face you will draw. And if it is asked the drawing of the brick, that time you have to draw the three-dimensional shape, that is the cuboid. Okay, so this is regarding page number 4. This you will practice. Then come to page number 9, math magic, page number 9. Quickly come to page number 9, math magic. There it is given some examples of arc. That also you will practice. Okay, the examples of arc like rainbow, bridge, tunnel, etc. So this also you will practice. Even some of the houses also, they have this arc design. Okay, now come to page number 10. Quickly come to page number 10. Here also some questions are given. That questions also you will solve. Regarding word problems, you will not have to write the statement. Only in the rough you will solve, you will calculate the answer, and then you will give a tick mark in the answer sheet. Okay, or the dot mark in the answer sheet. Clear? And listen, if you want to discuss about the app, then you are free to discuss. Don't do the class today. Okay, discuss only about the apps. Adrija and this one, Shorya. Clear? Better you discuss about the apps only in the class. Yes, there is the question that Munia wants to make a wall 1 meter long. How many bricks will she need to put in a line? So here one statement problem is there, and all the information regarding this statement problem, it will be given if the question comes in exam. Okay, you have to just solve it. No need to write the statements, just solve or calculate whatever the answer is coming, and then give a tick mark in the MCQ. It will be most probably it will be 20 MCQs. Just you have to give the tick mark or dot. Okay. Then there is one more question, that can you guess how high is the chimney here? The chimney, the height of the chimney. It is about 50 meters. Not here, in any others also, the chimney, it is about 50 meters height. Okay, so you have to give a 50 meters height. The give a tick mark in 50 meters size. Next, page number 11, there are the pictures of a brick clean is given. You have to arrange it in the ascending order. And I think you all know how to arrange it in the ascending order, isn't it? So arrange it in the ascending order and then write the order. Exactly. Now come to page number 12. Come to page number 12, math magic. In page number 12, see, it is written that 100,000 is also called 1 lakh. So this type of question you have done in the number system of composite maths, the international place value system and Indian place value system. So that number system also you will do for PT1. Okay, as I have given you the syllabus before only, the chapters which are in PT1 for math magic as well as for composite maths, the both you will practice for tomorrow's assessment. Okay. See, here some word problems are also given. Word problems that Bhajan decided to buy the new bricks from Brikabad. He bought 3,000 bricks. So how much did he pay? Now, cost of 1,000 brick is given. You have to find for cost of 3,000 bricks. So you will multiply and find it out. So no need to write the statement. Just multiply and write the answer. And the next question, guess what he will pay if he buys 500 old bricks? Now you have to find for 500 old bricks. Cost of 1,000 bricks is given. You have to find cost of 500. That means half. 1,000 bricks, the half is 500. So you will just divide by 2. Then you will get the answer. Clear? So in this type of question, the price of 1,000 bricks will be given. You have to find for either the half of the bricks, or you have to find for 3,000 or 4,000 bricks. Clear? So this is all about math magic chapter number 1. For chapter number 1, anyone having any problem building with bricks? Chapter number 1, anyone having any problem? Now come to chapter number 2, long and short. Come to chapter number 2, long and short. For long and short, come to page number 15. Come to page number 15. In page number 15, there is a question that Jhumpa. Okay, as you know that Jhumpa once read a list of the tallest people in the world. One of them was 272 centimeter tall. That is just double of Jhumpa's height. How tall is Jhumpa? You have to find the height of Jhumpa, and Jhumpa's double is the person's height, and it is 272. So what is the height of Jhumpa? So in that case you have to divide, isn't it? You have to divide by 2 so that you can get the height of Jhumpa. So this question also you will calculation you will do, not the statement problems. Clear? Now come to page number 16. Come to page number 16. For page number 16, there are some questions, word problems about this Rihanna and Arundhuti, Kuhana, Uma. In this question, if this type of question comes, the distance will be given to you. Okay, that means the distance of Rihanna, the distance of Arundhuti, the distance of Kuhana and Uma. The distances will be given to you. You have to find that what is the distance between them and the finishing line. Okay, all types of informations will be given. Just you have to calculate and write or take the answer. Similarly, the next one. See, in a 1500 meter race, people have to run dash kilometer. So for 1500 meter race, how much kilometer? That means you have to change in kilometer and then you have to write the answer. Similarly, for 3000 meter, you have to write the answer in kilometer. It is given in meters. You have to write in kilometers. Okay, just write it down and then give the tick mark. Adrija, 15 kilometer is wrong. 1500 meter is not equal to 15 kilometer. Here you have written 15 kilometer. It is wrong. It is 1.5 kilometer. That means 1 kilometer and 500 meter. 1 kilometer and 500 meter. 15 kilometer is wrong. Similarly, come to page number 17. Here also about the marathon race. You just practice the marathon race. It will come in exam, in the assessment. Okay. So regarding this marathon race, you have to find out for 10 rounds. You have to find it out for 10 rounds and then for how much will be the kilometer for the stadium track, that you have to calculate and then you have to give the tick mark. Okay. Similarly, the second questions also you have to find it out how many rounds he has to cover. So try to solve this also. And then the next question, the long question, that is Gurpreet and Gopi's jump, about Gurpreet and Gopi's jump. So that also you practice all the height or the longest jump. Aishwarya, switch it off. Switch off your front camera and stop singing. So the longest jump, the heights will be given. The longest jumps will be given to you. Just you have to calculate and then write the answer. Okay. Now come to page number 18. Please don't share the screen. Okay, now come to page number 18. Again, there are some questions. You try to solve that one. And from page number 19, the Devi Prasad. Devi Prasad also you will practice. Okay, Devi Prasad questions, whatever questions are given, that you will practice for page number 19. Then from page number 20. Page number 20, again there are two word problems. One word problem is that Shubodh, he is traveling from Kozhikode to Thalassery. What is the distance between that? That you will practice. And then Momun, how he is coming to school after crossing so many like the pond, the field and the road, everything. Then he is reaching to school. So what is the distance he is covering? That can also come in exam. Okay. So this type of questions, you no need to write the statement, only you calculate and then give a tick mark to the answer. Okay. So this is for math magic. Similarly, related to math magic, you were practicing composite maths, isn't it? Related to math magic, you were just practicing composite maths. For composite maths, chapter number 1, building with bricks, I think I have told you that you will practice this 3D shapes, large numbers, isn't it? 3D shapes and large numbers. Then addition, subtraction. These are the chapters for PT1. I think I have given the syllabus. Then measures of length. The length you will practice, measures of length. Okay, so see, for number system, whatever question, whatever MCQs are given in the question bags, that you will practice. The questions can come from the question bags also. Okay. questions can come from the question bags also. So try to complete from there also. Come to page number 33. Page number 33. In page number 33, there are MCQs of question bags. From question bag 1, there are some MCQs. Okay. Try to solve all the MCQs because questions can come from here. Okay. Similarly, for addition subtraction also, come to page number 59. In page number 59, there are some question related to the MCQs. That means the questions are given and MCQs are given. So this also you will practice. This also you will practice, the question bags. Okay, page number 59 and even in 60 also. Page number 59 and even in page number 60 also. Then the question bags of measures of length. Question bag of measures of length. That also you will practice. Question bag of measures of length. That also you will practice. Okay. Now, up to this, anyone having any problem? Up to this, anyone having any problem? Even for three-dimensional shapes also, you will practice the question bags. That is given in page number 240. Page number 240. Any doubt to anyone from magic or composite? From magic or composite, any doubt to anyone? You all are writing no ma'am. Okay, then you give the exam properly. And one more thing, for page number 40, just come to page number 40, everyone. Everyone come to page number 40. In page number 240, there are some nets given. See, you can see which of the following nets will not form a cube when folded. The nets are given, isn't it? You practice that one also. The net problem, the picture will be given to you. You have to write what is the answer. Okay, the pictures will be given to you. You have to write what is the answers. Yes, in math composite. Adrija, I am talking for math composite. No need to panic. The question is very easy. It is related to MCQs. 20 questions will come. Just you have to read the question and then you have to give the tick mark or you have to give the dot mark. Whatever is instruction there, you do that. Okay. Actually, we don't know what the computer has set, either the tick mark or the dot. So you just go through the instructions and then give the assessment. Okay. Not exam, it is the assessment. And it is very easy. With a calm mind, you will give it and practice the composite maths, the question bags. The questions will come from the question bags. Okay. Yes, the problem sums will also come, but just you have to calculate and give the tick mark to the right answer. You need not to solve it. Means you have to write the statement and like that. Nothing you have to do. Just you solve in the rough, okay? And you just give the tick mark in the answer sheet for the word problems. For the word problems, okay? Now, anyone having any doubt? Anyone having any doubt? Okay, when you are saying no ma'am, then it's well and good. I think tomorrow you will give a good exam and best of luck to all of you. So today up to this only, you give the assessment properly and then we will discuss about that in our next